Burley Griffins choosing to play four ladies on offense. So this game we have line assistants, Ruben Berg and John Mack. Sorry, game advisors. Game advisors. See them in the bright orange shirts on either sideline. They'll be communicating calls that are made on the field to those on the sideline. They'll also be keeping time during the points, so there's not two during in between points. Mike Connolly just sneaks that in for the score. Black Sheep taking an early lead, 2-0. Black Sheep with the pull. Black Sheep 2 wins so far today, Burley Griffins 2 losses. Anson Chun with the disc. Dance again. Lorna. To Mikey Hatfield. Nice, Alice. Got a hard match defense being put on here. Oh, lots of dumps, four of them, three of them. And a turnover. Wynn just picking up there during that point. Had been pretty quiet earlier on. And a turn. Down the mark there for 50 seconds. That was Emma Holdaway for Black Sheep with that turnover. And a score for the Burley Griffins. They get one on the board, 2-1 to Black Sheep. Back in now, James Green with the pull. Mike Connolly picks it up. That puppy fence that we've seen a little bit of so far today being utilised in defence. Just pulls that one down. Joe Seaback with a throwaway to Tom Fraser. I usually call him Kiwi Tom, but can't really do that today. A couple of Toms on the team. Might get confusing. Trying to settle it down now, Billy Griffiths. Danny Alexander with the disc. Playing the World Games. Team a few months ago. Straight up the sideline. Quite a nice crowd building. All the other games having finished for the day. Both sidelines getting packed with people. Tom Fraser now. Centers it, but it's home. Might be a call on the field here. Look to our game advisors for some interpretation.
Retracted
foul call. And our game advisors and some speakers here communicate to the crowd what's going on for any of these calls. It's a trial for Woofdoof, these game advisors. They are also allowed to provide some assistance regarding rules and that sort of thing for anything that happens on the field. But as always, no referees. It's to really assist the players on the field in their self-refereeing. Turnover there right on the line. This wind has just picked up again and tried to move it quickly, but a turn. Still very difficult position here in the corner. Tom Fraser runs that down, looking for the dish off. And a score! Score to Black Sheep. That's 3-1 now. Black Sheep with the pull. 3-1 now. Out on the full. Take a brick, no doubt. Jane Flay taking there from the brick mark. Back with him again now. Mikey Hatfield. That was some very sweet offense there from the Burley Griffins for the score, 3-2. Turn there, Burley Griffins. That looks like up. That is up. Danny Alexander with the score in the corner. Evening it up. 3-3 for Burley Griffins.
I was walking down the street on a sunny day. Feeling in my bones as I had my...
3-3 landed in that pool. Landed in, then rolled out. Looks like the Burley Griffins are... to set up his own defense here in the corner. Quite a strong backfield. Two quite tall players in James Green and Big Tom and Danny Alexander on the camera side wing. Eric with that fabulous hair. Loves his orange. Like Sheep looking to move it through the cup. Really just getting stuck on this sideline. Very tight defense. Carl with the Hammer cross field, trying to open things up to Tom Fraser. They did all the hard stuff, and then quite an easy throwaway. They're Burley Griffins now. And they turn it straight back. It's the upwind sideline over that side.
Thank you.
Again, trying to work it through the cup if they can. Over the top to the middle. Turnover, middle of the field. Very powerful position for the Burley Griffins to try and score. Needed a bit of communication there, the Burley Griffins. Should have been a score, truth be told. Black Sheep now, trying to work it up the field. Or hammer over the top, one or the other. Can't more. Again, really working hard on offense. More hammers. As I said earlier, Burley's looking for their first win of the tournament. Black Sheep have two wins today. Vicky say down. Spectacular layout, but I'm pretty. Yeah, he landed it. He's all there. Getting stuck on this downwind sideline. Very difficult from here. Can't more now. Danny Alexander with that D. That was on Kiwi Tom. Lots of turns so far in this game. The wind's got a bit to do with that, but not all to do with it. Adam Mortimer getting in the way of that pass. I was thinking there'd be less pucking in this game than there was in the university game that we just saw, but apparently not. And a scorer in the corner, Big Tom. Through to Vicky Slade. The Burley Griffins, 4-3, Burley Griffins. We will say there with the scoreboard, 4-3, Burley Griffins. Back live now, 4-3, Burley Griffins. So people have been acclimatising to the cold Canberra weather. I think it's going to be -2 overnight tonight. Quite pleasant at the moment. Wind's going a bit up and down. It's Mike Connolly picking up the disc. Getting difficult for me to see on the sideline, given all the people, which is great. Having to use the monitor. Lovely pass up the sideline. Tried to toe the line, but just went away with the wind. Joe Seaback it was with that pass. It was just a little overcooked.
Yeah.
And Mortimer centers it. Thrown behind. Yeah, definitely a miscommunication there. Let's see what Black Sheep can do, trapped on the sideline. Billy Griffin's in his own, but they get the swing away. That was a score. I'm not entirely sure how that happened from the side of the field, but it was a score. To Richard Fernando. Four all now. James Lay with the disc look, swings it out to Mikey Hatfield. Adelaide with the disc now to Mikey. Tom Fraser gets in the way of that. Wow. The D was good. Offense, not so much, and he's copying it well and truly from the sideline. Big Tom. Dropping what should be a pretty certain catch for him. Again, Huckfest all day. Either of these teams was watching the uni teams play just before, you would have thought they might holster some of those hucks. It's going to be a bit calmer now. As usual, commentators curse as soon as I say something. And this time they get the score. Mikey Hatfield, Big Tom. And a throw away there. Just threw it behind her, really. You'd think the Burley Griffins would have the home ground advantage because a lot of them would play at these fields actually on a weekly basis at league. And a score. Score to Burley Griffins. That is 6-4 now. 6-4 now, Burleys. Burleys with the pull as Adam Mortimer. But out on the full, taking a break. Thank you. Turnover straight away there from Burley. He's at the wrong end of the field. Layout D by Danny Alexander, what she does best, really. Ooh, bobbled in his hands, but he got it, Eric. Looks like Vicky with the disc now, Vicky Say. Pops it up. But out of bounds. Far side line. Nice defense there from Burley's. Black Sheep seem to have ripped through that zone, but just inside that sideline now. And a turn throw away there from Manson Chuck. Back into the zone. Back into the zone defense now. Swing. That was a fairly easy score in the end. There's now James Lay with the disc, trying to work it up through the zone. This sun very low now, you're probably struggling a little bit with our cameras. It's static with the disc, Burley Griffins. Could be an opportunity here for D. What a grab, that was a very nice grab. Hammer at the top to Mikey Hatfield. Want to move it now. Oh. Mike Connolly picks up the disc. Not in my house. Aussie Tom over Kiwi Tom. So Ruben Berg and John Mack being game assistants, game advisors. They're able to provide advice to players on the field. Help them self-referee the game better. There's also communicating any calls they made on the field to the spectators. Wind picking up now, and also the temperature certainly dropping as the sun gets a little bit low. Burley Griffins really struggling to get it to make much ground upfield. Lots of sideways movement, but then, as we've seen all today, taking the huck option. Oh, Timeout called. Nothing going on. Good option to call a timeout. Back now after the timeout. Fairly easy score in the corner in the end. 7-5 to the Burley Griffins.
Sorry guys, there's a bit of a technical issue there and our stream dropped out, but we're back.
Disc. Carmore. Set it up through the middle. Looking for a dump. Not much going on. And a score to Black Sheep. James Slater, Mikey Hatfield. Looked for the huck. Now just wants the dish here. Got a four-goal wall there from New Zealand, from Black Sheep. Carmore with that D. A 1-4-2 set up in zone defense there. Mike Connolly on the mark for women in the wall. And the two deeps. Black Sheep working it up and then hucking, but intervention there by the Burley Griffins. James Lay throws it pretty much straight into the wall there. Black Sheep swing it to the middle. Carmore with the disc. Oh, And a layup. Trying to do everything, that man. Mike Connolly now back to Carmore. Another D there by Carmore. To Mike Connolly. Oh, Danny Alexander gets a big piece of that, but straight into the hands of the Black Sheep.
New Zealand set to pull after the timeout. Stefan Pazzo in for a couple commentary points here. Pulls up. Nice upwind pull. Burley, but it does go out of bounds on the far side. Brick Colt. 97 for Canberra. Stretch to pick it up. That's James Lay out there with the disc. Burley Griffiths, the home team here at Canberra Mixed Nats. James Lay up to the brick mark. Little break throw there up the middle to 11 for Burley Griffin. Dumps back to Lay again. Lay looking at a forehand, steps across and gives a quick little dishy backhand. On the close side, ooh, just got handcuffed there and couldn't hang on to that. It was right in his guts. New Zealand picks it up, looks to go upwind here. These upwinders are big, big points in a knotted up game. Fakes the big one. 15 does, his dump came late. Now he goes up line, a beautiful throw up line, but the Burley Griffith defender dives between two would-be receivers for New Zealand, and he's going, he wants the double happiness. It's up, he's chasing, but not enough legs, a little too far. This wind sure does get a hold of it. Feed by ulti.TV. Some awesome work on their part with the pole cam set up ready to go. The staples of Australian ultimate coverage doing a wonderful job here. Dumps it back. New Zealand's got it in their own end zone here on this upwinder. A little hammer over top is good. Looks good in the wind. Fake backhand, fakes the big, then cuts through the cup. Zero for Burley Griffiths, gets a hold of it. 15 manages to grab it, plays from his butt. Now a big hot hammer. Oh my goodness, thought she had it, but I was wrong. She's put down right at her wrist there, 55. Is she still wearing sunglasses? I think that's happening. It could have been the sunglasses that put her off that extra inch. Who knows? Burley Griffiths, James Lay picks up the disc. Centers, 16 has it. Almost at the halfway mark. Dumps back, 23 with the disc. He surveys options. Faking, pivoting. Puts up a flick into the middle of the field. Has his man, James Lay, good 20 meter gainer. In the guts, middle of the field now. Lay dumps back, 23 with the disc. Puts a big forehand up into the end zone. Has a receiver, but can't hang on as she lays out. Action going both ways here. New Zealand with another chance on the upwinder. Taking their time, moving to the disc. A frigid early evening here in Canberra. The wind sure does cut through your outerwear. It's getting cold quick, although it's very sunny. There's a chill in the air. Is that put down in his own end zone? Unlucky there. Canberra now with a doorstep opportunity to just throw a 1 meter completion.
Oh,
James Lay picks the disc up, walks it back to the goal line. Is he going to do this in one throw? No, he resets, 23. Pop over top, Danny Alexander with the goal. Puts the home team in front, 8-7. DJ's on it here at AMUC. They're pumping the tunes as the points go in. Oh, that's halftime taken. We should have figured that one out a bit earlier, but Burley Griffiths take the half. We're back in action here, second half. A cracker of a game. Burley Griffiths take the half, 8-7, and also receive the disc. They are going upwind, however. Chamberlain, great pickup to prevent that going out. Saved himself a potential that bad starting point, I suppose, where they would have put their defense on, or if he touched it and rolled at the back, to start from the back of the end zone. Anyway, Scoober over top. And back to James Lay. 23's got it in the corner, fakes the flick, fakes the hammer, gives the flick into space, good throw. Handler has time, 26, sends a backhand back to the middle, James Lay. Up to 23, Lay again. Lay flick over to the far side, beautiful throw. Bit of a zone breaker, but they managed to get back over there. New Zealand with some big pressure on the throw here. Just checking out the action there. 23 dumps it back to Lay in his own end zone. Only moving backwards right now, but they can get their side-to-sides off. Ooh, almost a chance for the gainer there to 19, but she opts to hold it. Moves it to Lay. Burley taking their time. Now the hammer over top. Walcott with the disc. Fakes the big. Puts the flick over. 23 with the disc now. Fakes the flick. Gives the backhand that stepped in front. 24. A bit of telegraphing in that throw with the late fake. And New Zealand picks the disc up, going downwind now. Oh, big shot over the top, though. Just got her fingertips on it, but not enough to squeeze down. Burley Griffiths set to pick up. James Lay heading to the disc. James Lay winds up a backhand, doesn't deliver. Now a little outside-in flick, high release. Sent over again, close sideline. 23 with the disc. A little touch and go there, 1-2. 23 again with the disc, doing a lot of handling. Hammers over to Lay. Lay has a bit of time on the far side. He wound up that hammer before. He winds it up again, beautiful hammer, 23. Bit of a zone breaker there. They go gain a good 15 meters and then put it. It's a good matchup, two big boys down there in the end zone. Walcott gets there first, but can't hang on with the hot pressure defense there from the New Zealand defender. Giving sideline, that's John McNaughton there in the sideline, controlling the sideline as not necessarily an observer. I'm not sure his official title, but him and Ruben Berg basically running the game if anything's in question, and the clock, there's timekeepers. So I think that's the first time in an Australian Ultimate Championship, mixed or not, that we've had officials, so to speak, of that role. As the disc is sent deep but not complete, Burley Griffins with another chance to go upwind. Lay. Backhand, centers to 26. Coming out of their own end again here. Encouraged to keep working by the sideline, and that's what they need to do to get upwind. Scoober with a bit of a double helix on there, falls in number five's hands. She gives back to Lay. He wants that Scoober again by the looks of things. Elects the quick give and go dump on the sideline, staying stuck on that sideline. Beautiful upline throw there. Now centering. Is that too far in front? Just too far in front it is. Goes to ground, New Zealand with another chance. Flick, break right away, far sideline and upfield into the end zone. New Zealand's got two ladies there and one falls under very casually with one hand. I've got this, no problem. It's 8-8. We got a couple of snowmen on the board and it's all happening here in Canberra. Canberra receiving with the wind at their backs. And here comes the pull. Big floaty pull. Can land very near the opposing goal line there, but 6-7 meters up. Disc is up. Picked up rather. Ooh, and a clumsy little dump there, but hung on. The big one's up here. Number 16 for Burley is there first. 8 on the chase for New Zealand, and 8. Recent well with some great closing speed at the last second. Gets a little lefty finger on there and spins it away from play. New Zealand will get another chance to go upwind here. Scuba over top in their own end zone. Oh, Callahan play there for the Burley Griffins. 23 having a blinder, steps through and gets himself a Callahan. And they're going wild in celebration. Let's see if that can be the spark that makes them go on a little run here. Callahan. Number 12 settles under for New Zealand. He's been a highlight player for them so far this game. Set to number 1, who trips over the goal line there. We've seen a bit of play on that with these Porterfields. Earlier today, the Crank versus Supernova game. Timmy Booth had a bit of a trip over on the line that caused a very unfortunate turnover. A little give and go there up the line for New Zealand. And back and forth these two go. And Hooter goes there, short Hooter, number 2 with the disc, back to number 12. These two really working it together, running the show for the offense. And then here comes a big hammer over top. Oh, almost a collision. One in front of the other there, but neither able to hang on. Adam Mortimer backing his way up to the disc there. Vicky Say, his dump. He goes upfield with a break to Walcott as he slips through his heels there. Back to Mortimer. Puts a big flick up. It's floating. The Mohawk, Vanderboom, is under it. Lots of hands, just swiping, falling. Nobody can get to it. Well contested. Disc is in by number 2 for New Zealand. Swings it center in her own end zone to number 1 and 12 on the far side. A bit of a power position there. Oh, he sends it forward, and Adam Mortimer with a sensational layout D in the middle there. And Cooley calls the timeout afterwards. But massive defensive play there. Burley with a chance to score a huge late break while time cap's already gone. It's been dropping in and out the internet, but it appears to be fixed. We're hoping we'll have a smooth finish to this game and you'll get to take in all the action here on ulti.TV. Mortimer with the disc after that massive layout D in the middle of the field towards their own end zone. Their attacking end zone, rather. Disc is in. Mortimer looks for flick. Break flick. Too far out in front for number 7, but there's a call on the play. There's a call on the play.
Pick called before the throw.
Pick called before the throw. Some interesting renditions of what the signal might be for that on the sideline. Disc is in, Mortimer to Say. She winds up the flick and continues it over, 33 with the disc. Vicky goes up line, picks up a sensational left-handed layout grab. Dumps it back to Mortimer, keeps it alive, back to Vicky. Why not? She's playing hot right now. And Mortimer on the move. These two just taking their time right now, looking for the option, and here comes the shot. It's the two big men again, chance to win the game, and it is taken. Sorry, not to win the game, but for a big go-ahead break.
Canberra lead 10-8, game 2-11.
Disc is up. Burley Griffiths with a chance to win the game should they get a D and a downwinder. Can New Zealand spoil at this stage with an upwinder of their own to keep it alive? Far side. Handler dump there. Sends it up the far sideline. Fake backhand to the middle. Fake again. Having a couple jabs at it. Now the scuba over top. Handler continues with the forehand. 15. Dumps it back. Upfield to number 8 on the sideline. Fakes a backhand. Breaks around the cup. Gets a little bit of breathing room there. Now it's centered. Number 2 with the disc. Oh, big layout grab there by the New Zealand lady handler. She chomped hard. She's ripping hard to get those forehand fakes open. Oh, number 8 with a good catch on the other side of his body. And continues to 15 on the close sideline. Back to number 2, the very patient, and a stoppage.
Injury called.
Injury called, Ruben Burke. That's Danny Alexander, a standout player this year on the Crocs. And she's going off. She appears to be okay-ish, walking a little bit gingerly. And Vicky Say comes in for her. Frisbee is in the hands of number 15 for New Zealand. That's Tom Fraser. Puts it. Oh! And the Burley defender steps through, shuts it down, and Burley have disc in hand with a chance to win the game on this possession. I've already said they had won it in the past. I was wrong. And he's put it! Vicky says there on the chase. Too far in front with a great touch by number 55 from New Zealand to make sure nothing happens there. Big, big decision on that throw to score. Almost, but now New Zealand with the disc again. Extend the game is the hope. Disc is in. Number 5 for New Zealand to number 8. Hammer over top. It's going to get there. 15. Backhands. Looks to dump. Looks to go through the cup. Dumps it in the end. Back to 15. They're just working in the middle of this cup to number 2 right now. A little bit of short stuff right now. Taking the easies. Now a bit of a big dump. Back up the sideline. Number 8 busted through. There was a crash, and then he ended up getting it on the other side. He wants to go up the sideline. He does go up the sideline. They're taking small spaces. Now here comes a big hammer the other way. Oh! Gets to his other shoulder, and he can't get himself his body spun around quick enough to hang on. And then another turnover, and now New Zealand has a short field to work with. And a chance at a score to extend this game. Number 8 picks it up. 15 now. Sorry. Yes, it is 15 with the disc. Looks to set a little bit of contact on the mark there, a little push off. A little bit blocked by the crowd there, but I did see that hammer go up and over, and oh goodness, just over the defender there for the score, and it is an extended game, 9-10. New Zealand set to pull after a big upwind break to extend this game. If they can convert and get the downwind, we've got ourselves a universe point situation that the crowd always loves. And here comes the pull. sails down and lands in front of 26 for the Burley Griffins. Wind's at a bit of a lull right now, not too strong. And New Zealand playing man defense here. That one's out in front, 26. Oh shit, two chances, but can't hang on. Now New Zealand with a chance to extend this to Universe Point. Centered. Zero with the disc, backhand straight away. Great bid by the defender from the Burley Griffins, number 26. Gets in front as John Damiani shows up. The big shot's up, Walcott's under it. It looks like it's his all day long. I don't know if he was in. He's claiming it. The music is on. Celebrations have started and the DJ's been told to turn down the music. This party is not happening yet. I don't believe he was in from my vantage point here. I saw a straddle. It'll be interesting the outcome of this one. I can't see New Zealand conceding to give away the game. I do think it was a straddle. We've got the replay happening here. The call is not in. I think they've got that one right. One throw away, though. Burley Griffins. Sorry, we didn't get that replay, but we're back at you live. They're ready to come back in. Walcott's disc on the goal line. Disc in hand. 1 meter forward pass is the game winner. Oh! Big layout grab. And do we think he stayed in? Was he close to the tape? Or is that a celebration? That is a win. Burley Griffins get the home turf win, 10-9, 11-9 rather, over the Black Sheep from New Zealand. Excellent game, good showcase game. It's getting cold here in Canberra. Make sure you get onto the semis and the finals on Sundays. There's gonna be some hot action here in Canberra. You don't wanna miss a minute of it. Ulti.TV, get your fix. Live stream everyone.